Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fallout 4. This is not me again. Been looking forward to play this game since they announced it. You do not realize the joy I have in my heart right now that I have this game in front of me. So I've already had the game for probably about 2-3 hours. I've played just through the start up until the exit of the vault, just to see how the game played, and I can tell you it's fun, it's great, it's a joy, really. So without pushing it too far, I say let's just hit new game.
Changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish. The U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
That intro.
Never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hun.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
So this is the character creator. It's a massive departure from the likes of Skyrim and previous Fallout games. Now, I'm just gonna quickly hammer through this because I had one I liked in my quick start a minute ago. Yeah. Kind of like that guy. Step into the face now. I just want to drop the chin back a little bit with my very noisy mouse. And if I can just rotate him a bit. Right. The nose needs to go next. So the controls are a bit weird.
You look as good as the day we met.
A little bit difficult to get used to. I sink the nose back in. Cool. I can change the nose type by like hitting T. And I can just...
You think my nose is too big?
I'm a bit freaked out that your nose is changing so rapidly. I'm not going to spend too long on this, so don't worry. Very quickly, just go back in. Da, 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 da. I kind of liked The Urban Ranger, maybe. Oh, let's go Dapper.
Get a haircut yesterday.
Very simple. And give myself a beard, of course, because I am a bearded fellow. The Beast, nice. It's very similar to my messy beard just then. Let's go with the survivalist.
Beard or no beard?
She loves it, trust me. Ginger, no one. No. Auburn, maybe? That's pretty close.
Nice. Did you get a haircut?
Absolutely nothing like this in real life. That's one of the great things about our game. So let's be done with this. You don't get to choose the name until a little bit later. Hey, how you doing, Nora?
Good morning,
absolutely
sir.
Love the style. Hey, Codsworth.
Thanks, Codsworth.
Of course, sir.
It's absolutely tasty.
The Barbarian in the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
Now, if you just focus on the style for about 5 seconds, you'll see Bethesda has done a lot of work. The detail is just amazing. It looks great.
Never going to find that dog. Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
Sounds like someone made a stink.
Oh, sorry. Thanks, Codsworth.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Hey, hon.
Can't believe it's almost Halloween. Need to finish making Sean's costume.
What's Sean gonna go as, you reckon?
Wow, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh?
Damn straight.
More of the same. Hey, hon.
Nervous? Don't be. Everyone's gonna love the speech.
I like the TV.
It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Commie memes, lovely. Hey, buddy.
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Hi.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vault, if you will.
A little creepy.
Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Urgency? What's wrong?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning.
Wow.
Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Fantastic.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Why not?
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid. Splendid. Now, let's see.
So this just takes you into the point assignment. Gonna give myself my name first, of course. Not me. Again, hi, it's me. Now, from the previous Fallout games, I've gone more of a gunslinger route. Like, I like shooting stuff, because shooting stuff is fun, obviously. Perception is great for your vats. Endurance is okay. Charisma, I don't like talking to people too much. I'm a smart bastard. I'm fat. No, I'm lazy. I'm quite lucky, but perception and... I think endurance. I think that would be a good enough build for what I want to do on this, in this run through. So let's accept
Wonderful.
That.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down.
It's because you're a useless robot.
Some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
So, honey, why do we trust this jet engine around our baby? I mean, isn't that a bit of a fire hazard? What's up, baby cakes?
How are the two most important men in my life doing?
Oh, coochie-coochie-coo.
A bit. He loves that.
Okay. You satisfied? Oh, look at him.
Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh?
He seems to be.
Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir, Mom, you should come and see this.
Codsworth, what's wrong?
Followed by, yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds
what?
Of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with
say?
Our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania.
That is scary.
My God.
That's scary.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean.
Yeah, there's no time. Bye-bye, Codsworth.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Just go.
Keep going!
The vault is this way! Come on!
All participants, this way!
Now imagine, real life, the sirens going, the helicopters, everything. Would you survive? Do you have a survival plan? Are you one of these survivalists? I'm not. I would shit myself. I'm shitting myself and it's just a game. Whoa. Hey, big guy. Hi.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good. Come on, Nora.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Keep moving.
Come on. We don't have much time. I don't know when the bomb's going to fall.
Keep going. This way.
In the center.
It's going to happen, though. Come on, Nora. Thank God you made it.
Almost there. We're going to be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you, too. Oh, my God.
Holy shit. Oh, fuck.
Hold on!
Woo! Now, I've played that sequence before, and I still get goosebumps. I have them right now.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion. No need to worry, folks.
We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111.
I'm still in a bit of shock.
Underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No, no.
We'd all
Don't
be.
Get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Look at this vault. Just the entrance is stunning. Hey.
What? What's going on?
We just...
Hey.
Up the stairs.
We'll get everyone through this
okay.
as quickly as possible.
Up the stairs.
Just head up the stairs.
The level of detail in this is fantastic.
Take a vault suit and head down the hall.
Oh my god.
I'm glad you made it.
Hun?
We made it.
We did.
It's gonna be okay, right?
I think so.
Looks fine.
Over there. Still take your suit.
One vault suit. Now just head down the hall. You'll need your suits before we can take you further.
Okay.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three.
Thank you.
Follow me.
Come on, Nora.
See? This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love
it. Each of you take one of these.
This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C. Oh, God, honey. What if they didn't make it?
I know this is a difficult
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Good fit, don't you think?
Just all of these.
Off the list as they come in.
Prepared for the future, right?
Ha. Hey, buddy. You look good.
I hope you'll see this as your new home.
I hope so, too.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
So what's this? It's a decontamination
okay.
pod.
Sean's acting
okay.
up.
Will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Thank you.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4.
What?
3.
Did I just get tricked into stepping into a cryopod? Of course I did. I know this. Played this before. Shh.
Manual override initiating. Cryogenic stasis suspended. This is the one.
What are you doing to my wife? What are you doing?
Everything's gonna be fine.
Okay.
No, no, I got him.
Let the boy go.
No, you fucking don't.
I'm not giving you shots.
What the fuck? Right, man with a scar on his face. Remember that, boys. Scar on his face, left side. We're gonna hunt that bastard down for what he's just done, man.
Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
Oh, she looks frosty.
I'll find who did this.
I just picked up a wedding ring.
I promise.
Alright, I can spend hours walking around checking these manual releases. None of them work. I've done it before. But that sucks. Imagine waking up, seeing your wife getting killed, and then some unknown amount of time later, just trying to find her again. So all these cryo bays are pretty much empty. I can't get out of there. Hey. So, guys, this computer around here is the death computer. And I mean that. It basically just freezes my game. Every time I've used it, it's just froze my game. I was able to read through some of the logs, but then when I got up again, I was like floating in the air. I'll put some of those clips at the end of this episode. But hopefully Bethesda fix this. It's going to be a bit of a death trap for everyone who's just came in to use it. It basically says there's a problem with the main doors, which we know about, and that the only exit is through the Overseer's Tunnel, and about how everything's going to shit. Everyone's angry. There's no food left. They have to get out. That's pretty much everything that was in that machine, I think. So, I seem to be walking pretty slowly, but sprint is fast. I don't know if I've done something. Oh yeah, hit caps lock. So caps lock is for sneak. No, no bugs. I do not want bugs.
Giant roaches?
What There's the more hell? In there. So I can go in there. I don't think I've actually checked this room out. I don't trust you. I know I can come back a bit later and check this stuff out. So I'm not going to spend too long looking for loot. Just enough to give a room a quick once over. See if there's any major items of interest, like a gun or something like that. No, there's nothing here. Someone's been through all of this already by the looks of it. Why did they take my son? I'm a little confused about that. So that's a gameplay mechanic to show you electricity doesn't hurt you at all. There's a bug with the bugs. Hey, stop that. Now it's dead. I guess it just needed to move.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Okay. More roaches. Hey, I've got a power attack. I didn't know I had a power attack. Okay. In we go. Is this...
Is this all that's left?
What is this? Oh, nice. Overseer's terminal. Just gonna quickly scan through these. If you want to read them at your own leisure, feel free to pause. Okay. Okay, so there's not much interesting in that machine, but there's this thing called a cryolator. Preserved cigarette pack, nice. Anything useful? That's pretty cool. That's a nice detail there. Oh, what's this?
Nice. Coming back later for you.
No bobby pins. So I need bobby pins to act as like lockpicks. Is there anything else anywhere here? No. Alright, so there's one thing I need to do with this machine, and that is open the evacuation tunnel. It's doing that now for me. Excellent. Keep hitting escape. I keep thinking escape is the key to go back, but it's not. Ah, bobby pins. Pencils. Just pop all those roaches. Gross buggers. You can still hear them. Is there more? No. No, it doesn't look like there's more. Cool. So where are we going here? How about you just piss off? Do you have any idea how shit my week's been?
Did anyone get out?
This just loops me back round to where I've come from. And don't really have any intention of going back there. Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa. I did not see him. Oh, sweet. I like how the arm just fell out of that. Alright, so the Pip-Boy is like my interface to my character. I'm going to do all sorts of stuff with this. Play games on it. Listen to the radio. Look at my map. And I've also got the companion app on my mobile phone as well, from the Android App Store, Android Marketplace. And it works pretty well. I think I'll be using it as a mini-map more than anything else going forwards. Because most of my... Yes, it looks literally just like this. But most of my interaction with it will be, you know, using the in-game inventory and all that stuff. Because it's just a little bit too fiddly. What did I do? Did I just unlock that? Door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back. Now, some of you who would have played a game, Half-Life 1, the whole mechanics of that, this just evokes those kind of feelings. I mean, just like you see how things move and all the cogs and the lights. It looks fantastic. Clear. Oh, that's bright. Everyone's dead. Oh, that looks amazing. So, guys, we're about to see our first look of the outside since the bomb went off. And by the looks of it, it's been a couple hundred years. I'm not quite sure how long it's been. But I guess we'll have to find out in the next episode. Thanks for watching.